вопрос. Кто должен платить на первое свидание? Мужчина или женщина?
Конечно, мужчина.
Какое, вы думаете, самое главное качество в мужчине?
Он должен защищать свою девушку, он должен быть как стена, как опора для нее.
Важно, что он накачанный?
Нет, вообще совершенно не важно. Для женщины, которая влюбляется в мужчину, ей не важен его внешний вид, его подкачанность или животик, там, я не знаю. Ей важен внутренний мир, харизма в первую очередь и то, как он к ней относится.
И последний вопрос. Что бы вы сказали своему бывшему парню?
Бывшему парню, что он многое потерял.
Well, hello, my dear comrades. I see you are here because you would like to date, to marry, to make babies with a beautiful, incredible, probably smarter than you Russian woman. I am so excited about today's video, guys. I never get to wear this hat, so I thought I would use this very special occasion to do so and to just give you guys my opinion about what to do if you're a foreigner and you want to go meet a beautiful lady abroad. And before we get right into things, as I did in my last Russian dating sort of video, I want to give Alex from Reportify a big thank you and shout out. I'm going to link his channel in the description because all of the interviews that I'm going to be showing in this video are actually content pieces that I was shooting for his channel last year that he has very kindly let me use in this video. So a very big thank you to Alex. I'm gonna link his channel. He's doing some amazing stuff. Make sure you go check it out. All right, so the number one point that I wanna make right off the bat, that before you even start talking to the ladies, before you even start looking at the ladies, you should really understand what you are getting yourself into. I think it can be said without question that Russian women are not for everyone. We are difficult creatures at times. Quite a few of us are high maintenance and have very high expectations and usually, you know, have much more traditionally minded, you know, gender roles and relationships. Of course, globalization is happening all around the world and just cultural expectations are changing, but overall, Russia compared to the West is still a very conservative and traditionally minded sort of community. So if you are not somebody who shares those ideals, I don't know what you're doing there. Like, I don't know what you're expecting to find. Of course, you could find a needle in the haystack of, you know, somebody who's not any of those things. And of course, there's going to be varying degrees that people are those sort of stereotypes. But basically, what I'm trying to get across is that if you're looking to date a Russian woman, it's probably going to require a lot more effort than I think the average guy is used to here in North America. So just make sure that you are kind of on the same mindset and values as people in Russia, because if you're not, you're probably wasting your time.
Какие качества вам важны в мужчине?
Отзывчивость, доброта, честность.
Человек слово сказал, сделал. Она просто вот говорю, а не делаю. Мужчина должен поступать.
Надежный должен быть.
Надежный, чтобы ты была уверена в завтрашнем.
So if you have decided that this is something you are interested in, that you are committed to, now comes the question of how do I meet someone? Where do I go? How do I not get scammed on the internet? As I said in my last video, I am not an expert on all these bride and dating sort of websites that are absolutely rampant in both Russia and Ukraine and many other Eastern European countries. I'm not saying that they are all an absolute scam, but I would really caution you to be careful with, you know, which websites you use and the kind of reputation they have, how much money they're actually asking from you. I really don't see why it should ever be more than $100 to join a site like that, and then I assume everyone you talk to should be free, because if you were actually talking to a real person, wouldn't you think that you could just like add them on Skype or, you know, get their WhatsApp number, you know, see them in person is probably a very important point. Like, just make sure you're not paying all these singular fees to talk to a girl and then to Skype with the girl, you know, pay money to send her some kind of like gift to get more time with her. There are literally so many red flags when it comes to that kind of scenario. So make sure that the site you're using has a good reputation, that it's not too expensive, and that if you actually start talking to that person, that you can talk to them outside of the actual site. Another option is, of course, things like Tinder and probably whatever other kind of dating apps there are. And what you can do is, I think you have to buy the premium sort of version of Tinder, which I think, you know, probably is only $20-$30, maybe something like that, probably a whole lot less than these dating sort of agencies. And what you can do is you just change your location to be in Russia or whatever other country you want. And lastly is, of course, the most obvious choice of actually going to Russia and meeting people in person and kind of cold calling, so to say, once you get there. So if and when you have found someone that you are interested in, whether it's online or in person, my top tip to you is to be as confident as possible.
И многие мужчины, мне кажется, да, что мужчина был мужчиной, не девушкой.
Да.
У нас очень много таких женственных стало сейчас.
А, интересно. Мы как это больше слышим в Канаде и в Америке. Я не знала, что даже здесь у вас так и говорят.
В России тоже есть, наверное.
Ага.
And I'm not talking about the cocky or cheesy or just arrogant sort of confidence, not that you can even call that confidence, but just don't even bother using the whole like pickup line thing unless it's actually funny or, you know, just mainly commenting on her looks. Just something that is more open and direct and welcoming, actually taking the time to get to know her and what she's looking for, because that itself will help you. Women in Russia are generally drawn to men that are more confident and masculine, alpha sort of traits, so to say, that are able to be providers and that are also usually very romantic. So yes, it does go without saying that if you are able to go on a date with a Russian woman, you are 100% expected to pay for it. Like, yes, there are some feminists and some women who, you know, might think differently about, you know, finances and dating in Russia. Of course, especially with the younger generation, you're gonna have different sorts of opinions when it comes to that. But on a whole, even I myself was shocked of just how that is, how it is.
Кто должен платить на первое свидание?
Я думаю, что мужчина. Ну, я считаю, что парень.
Я думаю, что мужчина. Это будет более правильно, потому что мужчина обычно приглашает женщину на свидание, и для того, чтобы показать свое отношение к ней, он должен быть обходительным с ней.
I've never been to a country where the woman will not even offer to pay. So if you go on a date, like, don't be offended if she doesn't do the reach and, you know, offer to pay, because that's just not a thing there. Women in Russia tend to show men that they care about them in much different ways than, you know, buying them things, usually in more feminine sorts of ways, like cooking for you, doing things around the house, being very nurturing, spending 2 hours getting ready for you, because as we all know, men are very visual creatures. So of course it's a very different dynamic where, yeah, in North America your date might offer to pay for half, but like, don't even think of asking her to make you a sandwich. And my top tip for you of how to plan a good date is to really, in the beginning stages of when you were just first talking to her, is to get to know as much as you can about her so that you can later use those ideas to plan your date. So if you know that, let's say she loves to go ice skating, you know, if you're in the winter, you plan to go ice skating, you find out what her favorite food is, you take her to a show that you think she would like, find out what her favorite flowers are. Like, it's really not rocket science. Now moving forward, assuming that your date went really good, you're into her, she's giving you signs that, you know, she's kind of sort of interested in you, make sure you keep pursuing her. I find that in Russia, they're not as apt as we are here in North America to play these sort of games of like ghosting, of not being too interested in someone, you know, kind of keeping your cards to yourself. I would say that, of course, you don't want to be too much too soon, but make sure you make it known that you are interested in her. You want to keep growing this. You want to keep moving this forward. This is especially important if you are actually serious about this person and want to get to a point where you are thinking about having her move to your country, or you even, you know, moving to Russia. You really want to have that consistency there right off the bat. And lastly, what I would like to close on, and this point isn't even just for dating somebody abroad, it's for anybody dating anywhere and life in general, is that you want to enjoy the process. Something that I hate hearing from people, especially when they just came out of a relationship, is, oh, that was such a waste of time. If you're actually enjoying the process and taking things step by step without some kind of expectation that it has to get to a certain point at a certain time, you're going to get so much more out of that relationship. You're going to grow so much more as a person that even if it doesn't work out, it wouldn't have been a waste of time. So that is it. That is all of my tips to you guys, and I hope you found it really helpful. I would love to know what you thought in the comments down below, and let me know if you've actually dated any Russian ladies, how it went, what kind of recommendations you might have. And if you guys would like some extra tips outside of just this video, I assume most of you probably know that I was in a pretty viral video, if I do say so myself, like 5 million views of You Know You're Dating a Russian Woman When, and that was on the YouTube channel Dating Beyond Borders, and we shot that probably 4 years ago, not thinking that it was going to blow up to the magnitude that it did. And yeah, it's just a really fun video and is actually quite factual. And once again, a big thank you to Alex from Reportify for the interview content. I'm gonna link his channel in the description. And also I'm going to link the You Know You're Dating a Russian Woman When video, because that was really funny and has some good tips in there as well. But other than that, I am sweltering hot, guys. It is hot in this hat. It is like plus 25 today, so I'm gonna get going. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Love you so much, and keep being your own kind of beautiful. Bye, guys.
И которое самое главное качество в мужчине?
Забота о женщине, я думаю. Умение слушать и понимать. Ну, целеустремленность.
Качество харизма.
Важно, что он накачанный.
Нет. Нет, вообще нет.
Нет, совсем не важно.
Что-то среднее.
Среднее. И последний вопрос. Что бы вы сказали своему бывшему парню?
Не, ну я бы ему всего хорошего пожелала, потому что мы в хороших отношениях сейчас находимся.
Очень хорошо, спасибо.